Okay guys, so this is my tutorial on my insane e-commerce SEO link building techniques. And what we're going to do, we're going to focus on how you can basically build links to e-commerce sites, which a lot of people, you know, have a lot of trouble with, and then they rely on one technique, which is product outreach exclusively, which doesn't create a balanced link profile, sorry. So what we're going to do here is we're going to look at an example here of a keyword that's really interesting, carrier oils, good search volume, 390, ranking position 10. And what we're going to do, we're really interested in finding out if we can improve this to get it maybe in the top five. So ranking at number 10, we click on that. And just for anyone who's not aware of this software, this is SEMrush, and I have a 1 month free promo that I've arranged with SEMrush for you guys. So you can get that if you follow the link below, or if you are on the site already, you will see that on the page. If you're on my post, I should say. So let's click through, click on the number. This is our page, and what we're gonna do is actually click View SERP, and that's gonna show who's ranking. And here we go. So I'm interested in this result here. So I'm just going to command click that, open it up, and see this page here. So basically, we're not going to focus too much on, or actually not at all, on the on-site SEO element and why this page is good and deserves to rank there. We're going to focus on what they've done to create links to it, which have allowed it to rank position 5 in the whole country. But before we do that, we're actually interested in knowing, was that a lucky win? Did they rank for carrier oils and that was it? Or does this page actually offer them a lot more value? So we're going to go back to our SEMrush page and we're going to put it into here and essentially just see all the keywords that that page is ranking for in the UK, because that's the market we're interested in. If you're US, obviously pick this one, and any other country that's not shown here, just go to there. We're going to come down and we're going to look at all the keywords that page is ranking for. So we've basically got, yeah, we can immediately see some page one rankings here. Nice, perfect keywords appropriate for the page. And the amount of people searching each term is substantial. So yeah, my gut instinct was right. It's a good target and a good page to get inspiration from for how they've done their link building. So what we're going to do now is we're going to take the URL, we're going to put it into SEMrush. Now, I've already done it here, as you can see, it's all ready for you, and I've selected do follow links only, because these are links that are going to essentially boost the rankings. All of the other links, like no follow, they're going to be helpful, could produce referral traffic, but we're going to focus on these. So we're in there. Now, what we're interested in doing is finding a page which has linked to them. And the goal of this tutorial is to find examples of how you could also get featured, and not just in the old school way of just, okay, they've linked to my competitor. Great. I'm going to also try and, you know, beg and plead for a link. So if we open that up, as it already is, it's here, we see this big piece on this blog, and it's huge. This is like a mega resource. If, in my opinion, it's a bit too spread out content wise, but it's going to be a heavyweight page. So what we're interested in is looking at that page now and just first figuring out, so how did they link to the competitor? Well, Ahrefs very helpfully tells us the words that we used, so we can copy that. Go back to the article, Command F, Command V, and we can see here. So we're looking for context here. Could we equally get featured? Have we got something to rival any of these resources that he currently links to? And basically they're linking here. And due to the vast amount of information in this article, I'd say it's pretty likely that you could. But going a step further than that, we now know there's probably a high chance of getting featured, as long as the editor is, you know, keeping up to date with the website, which I already checked and he is. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to deadlinkchecker.com. Now, I've already inputted it all, but basically you input your URL of the blog post that you want to also get featured on. So we're looking at this one. We're going to select check single page and check. And what you come up with is all of the links on that page, which are some of which are broken, and that will be represented by a 404. And the reason we're looking for these broken ones is that if this editor is linking out to broken resources, that's an awful user experience for whoever's reading this page. And so he would be keen to cut down on that bad experience, and also gives you the opportunity as a website owner or the SEO for a website to come in, swoop in, and provide updated links for resources which are actually live. So now we need to look, Command F, search the page for keywords that are related to your topic, which is essential oils or carrier oils. So we're looking now and we see 67 different links that are, you know, associated with essential oils. And the goal now is to pick one and basically list all of the ones that are associated, because you could basically get in there and start, you know, pushing them out and you getting in. And rightly so, because they're dead sites or dead pages, so it's not a loss to them. It's not like you're hurting anyone here. So what we do, we take an example of any of these yellow ones, any of these URLs, we put it back into Ahrefs. Okay, so I pick this one. Before we start studying these, the first thing we need to do is find the admin of the site, because we need to let him know that this is going down, find his name, find his email, and send him an email simply letting him know that he's got loads of dead links, and you can highlight them to him, just some of them or all of them in this case, if you feel like it, and let him know that he could update the links with your new resource. Give him a little blurb or just the link and a bit of text to use to explain what you do. And whilst you're waiting for a response from him, you have now inputted one of those dead resources that you found on deadlinkchecker.com. You can then look at the backlinks that are also pointing to that page that he linked to. So we can see it's him linking and another one. And you've got to make an educated decision on if this site, is it worth trying to get a link from it? Is it going to benefit your SEO, or is it actually maybe going to harm it? And when you're doing that, you've obviously got to use your experience as an SEO to know what a good link and a bad link is. In the meantime, you know, when you're finding these resources, list them as well in a spreadsheet. So all of these yellows, we can start listing in a spreadsheet, because they're our prospects. We want to replace their footprint online. We can also search the page for carrier, because we're talking about carrier oils here, and we can find all of those. So carrier oils, apricot, carrier oils, kernel oil, and you can start listing them in a spreadsheet as well. And each of these results, you can do the same process. Look at the links that are also pointing to their resource, which is now dead, because all of those sites that are linking to them, you can approach them if you want to, if they're a good resource. So that's the main part of the technique. What you can then do to get more mileage out of this technique is look at your resource again and go back to Ahrefs where you've inputted it here, and look at the other sites that are also linking, so all the dofollow links, and then make an educated decision on if you can get in there. So for example, let's have a look at this one. Bella, what is she saying here? Bella Essentials. So we get that open. Now what we're looking for is a blog post which is linked to our competitor's page, but hopefully is not sort of in a sponsored post situation where she only will link to them. So what we can see is a hell of a lot of links going to Amazon. That's promising, not the competitor. We've got competitor, not the competitor. So this one is quite promising, because she's not just linking to that one page, which would infer, if she is just linking to that page, it would infer that when you approach her, she'll say, sorry, I'm obliged to only put links to their site for this particular post. And then you'll probably get sent a media pack saying, do you want to sponsor a new post? So that's not what we're looking for. In this case, pretty good example. You might have a good get in there. So what you do again, you're going to look for dead links. It's very, very unlikely there's any dead links here because there's only a few on the page. So you'll probably bypass this one. Close it down. Keep the search going for all of these which you think you can get in there. And in some cases, you're going to find, you know, they've listed various different essential oil providers, carrier oil providers, and you could just be added to the list. But what we're really looking to do is be helpful to the editors of these sites and say, look, you're linking to dead sites. Here's your dead links and here's resources to replace them. And so this process can be taken so far because we're only really looking at the links to this one competitor. So if you did all of that, you're going to get links 100%. But then what you can do is go further and say, okay, so what if we just look at other competitors? So carrier oils was the keyword. Click there in SEMrush. And we can look at other people who are ranking well and repeat the whole process again. And this process is going to be so much more scalable and cost effective than excessive product outreach. I will talk about effective product outreach and how you can do it in another post, but for now we're focusing on this one technique. And for this technique, you're going to need two tools really. You're going to need SEMrush. Like I say, I've got a promo code for you so you can get it free for a whole month. It is the most insanely good tool, so I would recommend that. And I've arranged with SEMrush for you guys to get a free 30-day trial, which you can find in the link below. Or if you're on the blog on my site, you'll see it there. It'll be pretty obvious. And the other tool is Ahrefs. And this tool, not as expensive, but doesn't do the same things as SEMrush. It's just, you know, for me, at the moment, I'm mostly using this for backlink analysis, so everything I've showed you. Okay, guys, so please let me know how you get on with that technique, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye-bye.